most important thing, I think, would be continuing to live life as I have lived it, fully and completely. I've been a rat bag. My mother, who's still alive, calls me her wild child. I never thought I was. I always thought I was a little pleaser, a little Miss Do-Good, you know. But no, I'm apparently a wild child. And I suppose if I look back at my life, that's probably pretty right. I guess I became disappointed in people in my late 30s, and I got seriously hurt by some people in my life, and I sort of thought, well, I no longer trusted people, so I'd thrown my passion into aviation. And of course it doesn't love back, but I have loved it every minute of it. It's just been brilliant. A, you're up there and you can be alone, you can go on your own. And I was coming back from an island up north the other week, and the tower had kept me a little high and as fast as this particular slow aircraft would go. And all of a sudden they said, clear the land. And here I was basically on the threshold. And I just raised the nose, dropped everything down, and it was like I was floating, and it was just bliss. It was absolute paradise. People seem to think control should only be done by force. That's when I say to the gentleman, hey, you know, you really don't need to work that hard at flying this aircraft. I guess you get more flies with honey than you do with vinegar. Well, it's the same, you get more out of an aircraft. I keep saying to students, just seduce it. You don't take your lover and bash them around the ears and then expect them to put out. You buy them chocolates and give them champagne if you've got any class. And the same with your aircraft. You put in what you want to get out what you want. It just happens. Like, I used to do very advanced aerobatics, really advanced aerobatics. And I used to think the freedom in that. But as I say, the other day, just out of nowhere, this feeling of floating, and